Hello everybody, my name is Joshua Winkins and welcome back to another video. In this video, I want to talk about digital minimalism and what it actually is and how to actually implement it into your life. Now, if you're new to this channel, I upload new videos every Sunday, Wednesday, and Friday, all about minimalism, self-improvement, and how to live a better and healthier life. Now, digital minimalism is all about simplifying your digital life, making your digital life a lot simpler, a lot more organized. Therefore, you're gonna be a lot more productive. Now, we live in a digital age, like it or not, and with this digital age comes a lot of blessings and a lot of curses. The curses are that technology can be a way to like distract us, to kind of not be productive. This can be gaming, watching Netflix, watching YouTube videos, just scrolling through social media. Now, there's nothing wrong with doing these activities, but a lot of the time these activities tend to draw us away and distract us from what we are trying to do. However, there is a side of technology that can actually be productive. With this new digital age, things are a lot faster, you can find things easier, things are a lot smoother. So actually, if you use your digital technology and your phone, your computers right, it actually can help your life a lot better, it can make you a lot more productive, and it can actually help simplify your life. However, most people don't actually take advantage of this technology. Like I said, the technology can be a ways and means to distract us from what we are trying to do, but it can also actually help us. A lot of times you'll ask people like, what's on your calendar? They'll check on their phone and there's nothing on their calendar. They didn't put anything. They'll ask you, or maybe you'll ask them, can you find a photo, the Christmas photo? They'll scroll through their 700 images on their computer where their desktop is completely a mess. And they say, oh, hold on a second, give me a couple hours to find this. If that's a problem nowadays, is we live in a digital age, but unfortunately not a lot of people are taking advantage of this technology that can actually help our lives, and most of us just criticize this technology and just say, oh, it's a means of distraction, oh, social media, YouTube, Netflix, blah, blah, blah. It's a place to just, all these kids just distract themselves with on their phones. However, there are some people that actually use these phones and actually use YouTube as a means of money to grow a business. So it's just something really important to understand is that we have this new technology, but most people aren't using the technology effectively, and they're actually just wasting a big part of their life, and their life is just completely disorganized. So the idea of digital minimalism is using this technology that we have, taking advantage of it, and actually using this to help simplify our life and just help our life to be a lot more productive. Now, I've broken down into four different areas in terms of digital minimalism, and I highly encourage you to go to each of these four areas and try to make sure each of these four areas are very simple and very organized, because if you take advantage of this stuff, your life is going to be a lot more productive. So the first one is your digital calendar on your iPhone, your computer. Just schedule out stuff. It's a lot easier when it's all digital because no one literally brings their calendar to work. Having a digital calendar is just a mini calendar on your phone. It just helps a lot to make sure your day is all organized. The second one is your Gmail account, your Yahoo account, or Outlook. Your email is really important and it can really help you organize your life, organize your day, especially if you're running a business. However, most people's emails are just cluttered with stuff that they don't actually need. The third and fourth one is your camera, your iPhone, places where you take photos and videos. A lot of times you keep photos and videos that you aren't even going to use and you can't find the ones you're actually trying to look for and ones that are actually going to help you. The last one is your hard drive, your computer, your laptop, anywhere where you store files and folders of your different photos and videos. Rather than just list off all four areas, I wanted to actually take it upon myself to go through all four categories and make sure each of the categories is very simplified, and all these things are going to help organize your life and help you to be a lot more productive. So I encourage you to also do this yourself. Go through each four categories and make sure each of the four areas is very organized and very just helps make your life a lot more productive. So the first thing I wanted to tackle was my digital calendar. I wanted to go through my calendar and write down like my daily routine. I wanted to black out sections for when I need to edit my thumbnails, edit my videos, and like record my podcast, and when my YouTube videos / podcasts actually are gonna come out. Now, I highly encourage you, not everybody's a YouTuber, so your schedule is going to be a lot different, but let's say you have a job, a part-time job, you're college or high school, highly encourage you to write down like when your job is, like when your shift is, and write down when your homework is due. It's really helpful. The iPhone, you have a lot of like gaming apps, stuff you can distract yourself from, but there are also a lot of apps that can actually help make your life a lot easier. So I highly encourage you to take advantage of your digital calendar and just block out your day, because from experience, when things are all organized, it just helps your day run a lot smoother. The second area that I wanted to tackle was my inbox. Now I have two different emails, both of them are on Gmail, but one is my business email and then one is my personal email. I highly encourage you, if you are trying to run a business or on a YouTube channel, I highly encourage you to actually create a separate business email and just have two different emails. Now the problem was, I realized in my personal email that I subscribe to a whole bunch of different newsletters like StockX, Goat, and I was getting all these emails that they're not actually adding value to my life. So I went ahead and just unsubscribed from all these emails. Therefore, every notification I got from Gmail, I knew the message was actually going to be important. So many times you get like hundreds of notifications from Gmail and only one of the two emails is actually something that's actually important, and you sometimes may miss that. So I just highly encourage you to go through your email, get rid of any, unsubscribe from newsletters, get rid of anything that's not actually helping with your life and you're just getting spammed. Highly encourage you to just get rid of all these newsletters. I have so many different companies with these newsletters that I subscribe to that just want to get rid of them. Highly encourage you to just get rid of all that stuff and kind of just simplify your inbox, whether that's Gmail, Yahoo, or Outlook. The third area that I wanted to tackle was my iPhone/camera. A lot of times I take a whole bunch of different thumbnails and videos and photos for my YouTube channel, and I actually don't use a lot of them. So a lot of the times I'll take a photo, then I'll put it on Lightroom, edit it, and then put it back in my phone and like my Photos app. And the problem is I have two different photos. One's the edited version and one's the unedited version, and I'm never gonna use the unedited version, so I've got a whole bunch of photos that I'm not even going to use. So I highly encourage you to go through your phone and get rid of photos or screenshots that you're no longer gonna need. Therefore, it's just a lot easier to post stuff to Instagram. You don't have to scroll through 700 photos and find the one you actually need. Same with your camera. If you're taking a bunch of videos for YouTube videos and a lot of them are like tests or lighting tests or just test thumbnails you're not actually going to use, highly encourage you to delete them off your camera. Because the problem is, when you go through and like import the footage into your computer, you don't know which one is the actual like clip you actually need. You have a whole bunch of unused clips that you're never going to need, so you have to like individually find the ones that you actually need. Highly encourage you to go ahead and do that. The fourth and last area is your like hard drive, your files on your computer. Highly encourage you, especially if you're a YouTuber, just make folders of different videos, YouTube videos, thumbnails, Instagram posts. It just helps make things a lot better. Therefore, you don't have like 500 images on your desktop and you have no idea which one's your thumbnail, which one's your video. It makes stuff a lot easier if you just help organize your files, especially if you're a video editor and a photographer. Anyways guys, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you think this video helped you, I highly encourage you to go ahead and share this with a friend who needs help simplifying their life. Their computer and the desktop is all messed up. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to leave a like, comment on the video if you enjoyed it, and make sure to go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I will see you guys in the next video. Peace!